Hey, this is Dave Davidson from Revocation. I'm going to answer 20 questions with metal injection.
What was your worst subject in school?
It was probably math. Yeah, I don't remember being all too stoked on math.
If Revocation was a flavor, what would it be?
Maybe like a salted caramel with a hot fudge swirl.
What's your favorite fast food?
I'm gonna go Chipotle. I know that's gonna make Dan very upset because he goes insane every time, but I think the quality of the ingredients and the fresh salsa, it feels like a healthy option even though it's probably not.
How do you spend your time off tour?
Teaching and just kind of playing guitar, working on music. I don't really have any other hobbies, I guess you'd say. It's just a lot of writing music and just kind of chilling out.
What's the best non-metal band ever?
I'm gonna go Guns N' Roses.
What's your favorite song off the new album and why?
The title track, The Outer Ones. It's super intense, super weird, kind of spacey, and the outro section has this cool kind of Gorguts meets Meshuggah kind of vibe that I really dig. And the solo is maybe one of the most ripping ones I've ever recorded.
How much music theory does Revocation use while writing?
It's a hard question to answer because like I think a lot of the theory, like you learn it and kind of get it baked into your brain and then you try to sort of forget about it so that you're not constantly, you know, it's not at the forefront of your mind when I'm writing. Like I try to be more just like let it soak in, and then as things come out I can sort of analyze them after the fact. But I don't think I'm like sitting down necessarily being like, oh, I'm going to write in this particular mode or whatever. Or if that does happen, it's more infrequent. It's more kind of after the fact, like analysis. If I'm working on like a solo or something like that, I'll have to like know what key it is in or like what the chords are. That's when I'll use the theory. But as far as like composing riffs and song switches, I'm just kind of like feeling it out and what vibes right with me.
What sport are you the best at?
I don't think any of them, really. I was never too good at sports, but I did karate. I don't know if that's a sport as a kid, but I don't know. Maybe basketball, I can kind of dribble a little bit. Not really, though. I wasn't that good. They always put me like in the outfield, like all the sports. I was just like just throw him out there and just let him hang out, let him marinate out there.
Tell us something about yourself that most people don't know.
My initials are DND, which could also be Dungeons and Dragons.
What made you pick up the guitar?
Joe Perry, watching Aerosmith. I think it was like the Fall in Love is Hard in the Knees music video or something like that, like right when Nine Lives came out. Saw that, he looked so badass, and it was all over from there.
What's your favorite memory involving Revocation?
I think playing one of our first headline shows at Vitus, where it either sold out or got close to sold out. It felt like a turning point for the band, and just seeing that many people come out and be supportive was a really good feeling.
What's the last thing that you watched on Netflix?
Okay, so I'm super late to the party, but Breaking Bad, I just got into it. So I'm on like season 2 right now, episode 2. Things are heating up in, you know, that meth lab kind of way. You know.
What's a pet peeve that you have?
Maybe like super picky eaters. It's like, just eat the food. It's good.
What meal can you cook the best?
I can do a good chicken cordon bleu. Well, let me spell out the whole meal plan here. So we got chicken cordon bleu, and then I'll do like maybe like a sauteed asparagus, you know, what's left over from the chicken cordon bleu, and then I'll do like a garlic dill mashed potato on the side. So all that together is perfection.
How would your friends describe you?
I would hope nice, I mean, funny, an overall good guy. Or they think I'm an asshole. It's one or the other. I don't know.
What is the grossest thing that you've ever put in your mouth?
I don't think they're gross, but like some people probably get like sketched out by like oysters. I ate like raw horse meat in Japan, like horse meat sashimi, so that would probably bum some people out. But it was pretty good to me.
If you had a superpower to help your career, what would it be?
Money. My superpower would be having lots of money.
Tell us something nice about your band members.
Brett's a super hard worker, very focused. Dan, excellent musician, got one of the best ears in the game. Really comes up with super interesting parts. Ash is definitely an explorer, so it's always fun to go on adventures with him and, you know, walk around different towns, see new sights.
What's your dream car?
I've never really been a car guy. I don't really care that much. I really, my dream is just for my Honda Accord to not keep breaking all the time. That would be my dream. It's like, it always smells like gas. There's just always something wrong with it where I'm like constantly having to take it into the shop. It is a 2002, so maybe a new Honda Accord, maybe. That would be cool.
What's the best advice you can give to another musician?
Work really hard. Try to find your own voice on the instrument. Don't try to go with what trends are happening. If you just sort of stay true to yourself, people will eventually come on board. And if they don't, at least you have your integrity, right? Thanks so much for listening. Pick up the new record, The Outer Ones, September 28th. See us on tour.
Sorcery of the black door with 1,000 years.